Dion, set to open at Busch Gardens Williamsburg in 2021, was officially announced in July of 2019 to be America's fastest multi-launch coaster. It wasn't just speed that put this coaster atop of many enthusiasts' bucket list. It was also the fact that it had a beyond vertical 95-degree drop, a maximum height of 178 feet, a length of 3,828 feet, and a wicked 2 launches. Now, those are all pretty awesome stats, but what do I think of the coaster? I'll be getting into that in today's video, as I'll be analyzing the entire coaster. Let's get into it now, starting with the official animated POV. You dispatch from the station and enter a few low-to-the-ground, slowly-taken turns that send you past a few rocks and under a pedestrian bridge. Then you enter your first launch, which boosts you up into a 0G roll. You roll out of that and dive back towards the ground, where you enter a few small airtime hills that are sure to be fun, but nothing outstanding. You then roll into your multi-pass launch. This multi-pass launch will work by you boosting up to a speed that is not quite fast enough to clear the top hat, so you will then roll back down the track. You will re-enter that same exact launch and you keep going, as there has been a switch track which has changed the direction. This sends you up a beyond vertical spike. You then fall back down, re-enter that same launch for a third time, and now you have enough speed to successfully clear the top hat, and you do just that. You then dive down your 95 degree drop before entering a low to the ground turn. You then rise up into a snappy outer bank turn, which is sure to provide a lot of sustained airtime. You then rocket through a 0G stall, which is sure to provide a lot of hang time. You then pass under your 95 degree drop before snapping through a few low to the ground twists before one last outer bank turn before the brake run. So yeah, that concludes your ride experience on Pantheon. It's a little bit short, but not surprising considering that it is a modern launch coaster. Now, I want to get into a few specifics that I haven't talked about just yet. This coaster will run 2 20-passenger trains manufactured by Intamin, and with Busch Gardens Williamsburg's relatively fast operations, this coaster should have a pretty high capacity. And BGW does have some specifically themed areas to European countries around the park, such as Ireland, Scotland, Germany, and England, just to name a few. But this one will be located in Festa Italia, along with other rides such as Tempesto and Apollo's Chariot. And just like those other rides, it will not have a ton of theming, but it will be presented very nicely. A concern that many have regarding this coaster is its reliability. Since this is an Intamin and unreliability are connected at the hip, many are speculating that this coaster might have a lot of downtime, and for good reason. A lot of Intamin's coasters, both past and new, have not had the best track record in terms of reliability, so that's definitely a chance to happen with this one. But since this project got delayed by a year because of the Rona, BGW has had a whole nother year to work out the kinks on this coaster, so hopefully it goes over well. And finally, I know that a lot of people have been foaming at the mouth over this addition, saying that it will be one of the world's greatest coasters. However, I don't think that I particularly agree with that train of thought. Yes, Pantheon looks like a really fun ride, really solid airtime, some hang time, and an overall great experience, but for me, it does not get much more than that. It looks like a fun experience, nowhere near the best coaster on Earth, not even the best in its state. I think it looks like a great addition to Busch Gardens, and I'm really happy that they're getting a new custom coaster like this. However, it doesn't seem like it will be all that much more than just a fun ride experience. However, I am certain that everybody will enjoy it. But I'll never be one to complain about a new Intamin. But at the end of the day, those are just my thoughts on Pantheon coming to Busch Gardens Williamsburg in 2021. What do you think of this coaster? Let me know in the comments down below. But that'll be all from me. So be sure to like this video, subscribe to the channel, and I'll catch you guys next time on Hang Time Thrills.